Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. This is my third video based on Internet of Things video lecture series. In this video, I'll be discussing about advantages and disadvantages of Internet of Things. Let us start this session with first agenda, that is advantages of IoT. See, with the use of IoT, we will be making our process automatic. So IoT leads to automation and there will be technical optimization. See, technical optimization will be done with the use of some parameters, right? If you make things automatic, if decisions are taken automatically with the use of application on cloud, then you'll be observing your process is getting smooth and production quality is even improving over here, right? When we talk about wastages, then with the use of IoT system, we will be reducing wastages and we will be using our natural resources effectively. When we talk about human efforts, then here we are minimizing human efforts and we are saving time. See, in Internet of Things, when you make application, at that time, there is a need of less interaction of human efforts, right? So automatically you will be saving time over here. The reason is decisions will be taken by IoT applications, right? So here there is a less need of human. In some critical situation, human can take even manual decision over here, but in normal situation, automatically decisions will be taken, right? Here, you will be saving cost of the production. We will be having improved productivity over here in our application and it will be enhancing product quality as well. Here, we can have timely actions, right? And based on that, we can avoid some accident. See, if you take actions manually, in that case, there is a possibility that you may not be able to take actions on time. Because of that, there can be some accidents, right? So in real-time applications, in critical applications, it is highly essential that you should be having automation. And if that automation is happening with the use of IoT, then there are many combinations that can be provided by which we can avoid accidents, right? Here, when we talk about IoT club with AI, then we can improve model or process behavior over the period of time. And that is what the case which is happening nowadays, right? See, asset tracking that you might have observed with many applications, like if you order something on Amazon, then you can track asset as well. You see what is mentioned here, asset tracking, traffic or transportation tracking, inventory control, delivery, surveillance, individual order tracking, and customer management can also be made more cost effective with the use of right tracking system. If you order something from Amazon or Flipkart, you can track your product, right? And even that product can be tracked by that service provider as well. So because of that, it will make that system cost effective and user will be having better experience as well, right? Here, IoT embedded with big data helps user to extract useful information from pool of raw data. Usually you will be observing, we will be having lots of data, right? And if you have lots of data, then you will have to extract useful information. So in big data, if you have raw data and if you extract useful information and if you process on it, then you will be doing meaningful activity, right? So that is what the case which we do it with IoT applications, right? Here, IoT improves monitoring with smart sensors. See, sensors are integral part of IoT. So along with smart sensor, you will be improving monitoring of the application, right? You can monitor many things. If you want to monitor temperature, if you want to monitor leakage of gas, if you want to monitor weight, you can monitor as many parameters as possible, right? So all the physical parameters can be monitored over here with the use of Internet of Things. For that, you need to have sensors integrated with your applications. Here, prediction and analyze the outcome of the operation and business, right? So with the use of deep learning, we can have prediction and we can analyze our outcome as well. And if you can predict and analyze your outcome, then it will be helping you in your business, right? it is used to identify fault location as well. See, if some faults are there, then also we can identify it. The reason is everything that is there in structured way and all the data that is available on cloud. So tracking of elements, that is quite easy over here in IoT. In manual control, human will have to observe everything, but if you have all the data available in front of you, then identification of fault location, that will become easier over here, right? See, asset information can be available in real time. The reason is continuously all the data that is forwarded on internet. So in real time, asset information is available in front of you, right? Now, let me explain you disadvantages of IoT. So when we talk about disadvantages of IoT, then you should know it is vulnerable to attacks. See, as everything is available on internet, there is high probability that hacker may hack the system from internet. So it is always vulnerable to attacks, right? Here, maintaining privacy, that is a major challenge. The reason is all the users are accessing information from the internet. So maintenance of privacy, that is a major challenge over here. You will be observing security of confidential data is also key concern. The reason is all the users are uploading their data on the internet, and as if somebody is hacking the system, in that case, security concern of confidential data, that is a key concern over here, right? When we talk about dependency of this applications, then that is purely based on the internet only, right? So here there is a huge dependency on the internet, and that is why issues are getting generated. Here dependency is also there on many devices and software. See, IoT systems are having hardware part and software part, right? Major software part, that is there on internet where algorithms are running. And at hardware side also, there is a dependency. There will be sensors, there will be embedded system, right? So there is a dependency on internet as well as there is a dependency on hardware part as well. If sensors are getting failed, then your system may not work properly. When we talk about control, then we may lose control of our lives. Why? The reason is things are getting controlled on internet. As if servers are getting failed, in that case, that is quite possible that we may lose control of our lives, as humans are not having an idea about how things are happening right now. But if servers are getting failed on internet, then that is quite possible over here. See, there is a big risk of losing jobs, and that is happening nowadays. You know already about those things, right? As IoT and AI that came into the picture, many people have lost their job, and that is because of high production with low cost, right? So risk of losing job, that is there because of IoT. See, it is difficult to plan, build, manage and enable broad technology to IoT framework. See, as if you have, many users for given application, then one can plan about it. But if number of users are less, then it is quite difficult. The reason is you need to think about cost as well, right? Here, you can say it is incompatible with some standards among different operators. The reason is there are varieties of operators, those who have been providing services, right? So here, many standards are incompatible. Country-wise, even you will have to observe like how standards are there. In Dubai, temperature is high, so standard of devices, that will be even different. If you talk about Canada, in which you'll be observing temperature is there somewhere around negative temperature. In that situation, standard of sensors even will change, right? So incompatible IoT standard, that happens because of region even, as well as there are different operators, right? So even with respect to operators, standard changes. Like in Germany, standards are different. In India, standards are different. So as if you want to make your system compatible to all the users, then that is quite difficult over here. That is challenging task. Here, see impact of overuse of IoT on people's health, right? As if people are using so many applications from IoT, then what will happen? You know, like there will be some health issues. The reason is if you don't work, right, physically, then automatically, some issues will happen with you. So it is highly essential that you should be having some physical activity by which you can protect your health. So that is how different disadvantages are there with IoT system. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Still, if anything that you like to share, Please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.